Hello everybody, this is Angie, and today I have another dollar idea for you. In case you haven't seen any of my dollar idea videos before, I set two rules for myself. First, the item that I'm working on cannot cost more than a dollar. It can be less, but not more than a dollar. The other rule is, once I alter it, I can only use what's available in my craft room. I cannot go out and buy anything additional. So what I have for you today are two different pincushions. And here's a little baby shoe. I promise you, incredibly easy to do. And with this one, I just went ahead and worked on a teacup with a little dangle charm here. And these are incredibly easy, and the stuffing is something you probably already have in your pantry. So I'll go ahead, move this out of the way, and I'll get started with the instructions. Be right back. Okay, to make the baby shoe pin cushion that I just showed you, I was given this set of cute little wide baby shoes. You're going to need the baby shoe, of course, and you can find these in the thrift store. I did find some real beat up ones a few years ago, and I'll show you what I did with those later. But anyway, any baby shoe will do, because you're not going to alter it. You're not going to hurt it or harm it or change it, unless you really want to. So you could always give the shoes back to somebody, or let someone use it for their baby or whatever. Any piece of cloth for this, I use a thicker piece of cloth that I have in the craft room, because you're going to be sticking your pins in it. But any piece of cloth will do. I have a couple of rubber bands here, and to stuff the pincushion, I use rice. And it's incredibly hard nowadays to find short grain, but this is medium grain rice. It really doesn't matter, but the smaller the grain, the better. But I'll go ahead and show you just how easy this is, because you do not have to sew a thing. But because all of the baby shoes are a different size, of course, you're going to have to cut a remnant. And I didn't even size this. I just eyeballed it, because this baby shoe is a wide shoe. It's got a wide opening. So I don't want to tell you the measurements, because it will depend on the size of shoe that you have. But it's best to have like a larger piece, because you could always trim it out. All right. So once you have your remnant cut, put some rice. Okay. I guess it's best to go ahead and do it this way. Put the rice in the middle. Carefully gather it around into like a little ball. And try to make it kind of round when you're gathering it. And you could look at it. Okay, kind of round, kind of round. You could move that rice around and see if you have like a little ball. And you gather it up with your rubber bands. Kind of make it tight. This is so easy, and it's so much fun to do. I mean, you could do this with the kids. Alrighty. Try to make it tight. Okay. Take your baby shoe. Open it up. Open up those shoelaces. Now, on the one that I had shown you in the very beginning, because it's the same set of shoes, I took this black out because it doesn't show. I used an old shoelace, and I dropped it in some tea that I had left, and I tea stained it to make it look more vintage. But you just pop this right in here, and you move it around, and that's what's so nice about having little pebbles. You could work it in and all that kind of stuff. And then you tie that last lace in if you want. Hard to do these little things. And voila, you have a pincushion. You haven't harmed the shoe. I mean, if you want, you could always give this, take this out, change it out. If it this wears out or you want a different material later on, you can do that. Now, what I did with this one was, again, that see, I used a different color of the regular kind of shoelace. I dropped it into some tea and tea stained it. And then I just cut a little, like a rectangle of my cardstock. I stamped it to make it look like a little vintage inventory tag. And this is a real cute scissors charm that I found on eBay. They still have them, and I think they even have the silver ones. Now, if you want, you can just go ahead and type something on your computer, print it out on whatever kind of cardstock you have, use your little $1 hole punch, and boom, you have it right in there. And if you don't know how to make stick pins, that's fine because you can get these really pretty pins, decorative pins, in most craft stores. I found them mostly in the craft stores in the floral section. I think Walmart might still have them in their floral section or bridal section. And they're not very expensive, and they look really fine. And if you want to go ahead and make some cute little stick pins, there's a lot of tutorials out there on how to make stick pins. Now, for the teacup, it's just as simple as that. You could take the one you just made, oops, plop it in the top, put a little bow on the side, put a little charm, another scissors charm that I have, and you haven't ruined your teacup, but you certainly have a cute little thing that you can use. Now, the beauty of the teacups is that most of my thrift stores always have teacups. Maybe not this intricate, because this is one of my bone china teacups, but they always have teacups, and they always have them for like 50 cents to a dollar. And it's just as easy as I showed you here. You could pop a couple of flowers in there and dress it up. And again, you're not altering. If you have a pretty teacup that you don't really want to permanently alter, you could just press those in as pins. And you have a pretty little teacup pin cushion. You have a cute little baby shoe pin cushion. And if you really, really want to get on it, this is one of the first ones that I did make. You could really go to town and put all kinds of flowers and things on it. Get yourself a pretty remnant of satin material and do that. And put a flower on top. This was one of the first ones I did. And I think I did a video on that one. And then, let's see, I used some lace and did this one. So you can do whatever you want with them. These were very beat up. I got them at my thrift store, very beat up. And I just used wall paint to paint them and color them and then just started hot gluing stuff on there. So, again, you could always alter these inexpensive items and give a very, very unique, handmade, thoughtful gift to anyone out there. And the beauty of it is, too, is most of us need pins. We may not be professionals. I mean, I did do a lot of sewing when I was young, and we may not be seamstresses and all, but a lot of people need pins. So it makes a cute little thoughtful gift that you hardly spend any money on, and you did quite easily with things that you have at hand. And a bag of rice is very inexpensive. So I hope you like my dollar idea. I do have a series of them. And if you're interested, you can go to my channel and put just the word dollar idea. It's a $1 idea. And those are easy to do also. So I thank you for watching. I thank you for your comments. I read each and every one of them. And, oh, yeah, if you have any questions, please feel free to write them down there. And I am wishing you a wonderful, creative day. Bye now.